Yeah, this is ChosenFewTV, and today I'm gonna give my testimony. Well, you know, I haven't always been living the Christian lifestyle. There was a time when I was in the church, and then I had to say, you know, I consciously decided to backslide and to come out from amongst the church people because of offenses. I ended up, you know, selling drugs. I ended up home invasions. Ended up whatever you can think of. I've done arson, pimped women, like whatever you can think of. I've pretty much done it, you know. So basically what happened was, along the lifestyle of, you know, being a drug dealer, one day God decided he was gonna call me. What happened was, I went to a bar and there was this lady there, and she was just talking, you know, all up in my ear. Like, I really didn't want to have really anything to do with this lady, seeing how I was like 21 and she was like 46. So I kind of felt like, yo, what's this woman really doing? Like, why she hollering at me like this? And long story short, she started talking to me about the colors I was flagging, you know? A flag and a red bandana, and she's like, yo, people die for this every day. And I'm like, really, what's this lady talking to me about? Like, the way I was set in a place where I was like, whatever happens, happens, and if someone wants to talk rowdy, we can be about it, you know? But push come to shove, you know, that never happened, thank God. Because you never know where I could be right now. But anyway, so the lady started talking about my, you know, I was about my flag and everything. And she's telling me that this could get me got. And I'm like, really? Well, all right, if that's how you see it. And she's like, no, it's not how I see it, it's what it is. And she kept going on and on and on. Me, I'm looking for an out. But then something told me, look back at this woman. And as I look back, it's like all the drunkenness that was on her, it ceased to be. And all I could see was like an aura of light all around her. And I was just like, word? What's going on, you know? And then she just asked me, like, how long have I been knocking? How long have I been talking? And I'm like, what? In my heart, I didn't even speak it out loud, but I was just like, Jesus? Yo, this woman, she looked at me in my eyes and she told me, oh, so now you can hear me. And me, that took me back, you know. I had to get up out of the bar and just leave. I was like, forget this, like, what's really going on, you know? So anyways, the next day, well, occurrences just kept happening, you know. It was like rapid progression, you know, to get me back to God. And the next day I went out, was at my girl's house, and you know, as I was there, you know, me and my boy were there, we were smoking weed, drinking, just chilling. And about midnight, we heard this cackle, like a witch slash a goat, that's what it sounded like. And it went all through the house. And me, I'm thinking I'm hallucinating here. But I'm like, there's no way that I can hallucinate and this man will hallucinate the exact same thing at the exact same time. It doesn't happen like that. So I'm like, yo, did you just hear that? This man's like, yeah. But he was like frozen, like, you know, like he shook one. Anyway, so as I'm like, you know what, we can fight this thing. And he's like, nah, don't try. And I'm like, nah, man, we could fight this thing. Yeah, so me, I'm like, we could fight this thing, real talk, dude. And he's like, nah, don't try that. And me, I'm like, no, we can fight this thing. And then this man, you know, I stood up and I'm like, in the name of Jesus, you know, like, it's all coming back to me now, you know, who I am and all. And I'm like, in the name of Jesus. I said, in the name of Jesus. This man got up, cut out the house in lightning speed. Like, he knew something was going to happen. Mind you, he's a Rasta who believes in Jah Rastafari, Selassie, Elim, huh? But anyway. Anyway, so this man cut out the house quick. I'm standing up in the place and I'm like, in the name of Jesus, I demand you reveal yourself right now. I felt diff, like ice cold hand gripped me, and it felt like bones, you know? And I'm like, dang, And I'm looking around for this man, and I see him way outside the door, you know? And I'm like, yo, did you just touch me? The man look at me like I'm nuts, and he's like, dude, I'm all the way over here. How did I just touch you? I'm like, good enough for me. I left the house quick, yo. I left, I came back the next day. Me and this dude both came back the next day. We're like, yo, whatever we was smoking last night, we'll leave that stuff alone. We'll sell that stuff. So we went back to the next night, and we're over there smoking up some different stuff, drinking some different stuff. And we heard the cackle again, same cackle. And we're like, yo. I'm like, nah, nothing's chasing me out of this house tonight. This is ridiculous. This man decided he's getting up and he's gone. He's not sticking around. But me, I'm like, no, no. No spirit is going to chase me out of no place. Like, you chased me out once, fine. Not twice. You're not chasing me twice. If anything, I'm going to chase you. But anyway, so I stayed there. Then my girl got back from, she was stripping and everything, and she got back and she's like, yeah, so as if you're still here. You didn't get shucked off? And me, I started thinking, what? And she's like, never mind. And I'm like, what's popping, you know? So anyway, that night she decided she's gonna go off into the washroom and do her hair or whatever. And me, I'm following her, talking about like, yo, something's wrong with you, you know? Like, not necessarily with you, but something's around you. And you know, long story short, at midnight she was in the washroom looking off in the mirror. And I told her, yo, look at me. And I looked in her eyes and I told her, in the name of Jesus, I'm not talking to you, but I'm going to talk to whatever's up in there. Because listen, the eyes are a window to your soul. And if I talk directly at you, looking into your eyes, whatever's there will come to the surface. She kind of played it off like whatever. But yo, I live and breathe. I told the thing, you, in the name of Jesus. You, I'm talking to you, you little coward. Come out here, we have to have a conversation tonight. As the clock struck 12, girl fell asleep. As the clock struck 12:01, girl's eyes opened, veins. No pupil, no nothing, veins. Girl's coming at me like on some demonic tip, and I'm like, whoa, 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 what's going on? So I'm backing up here, cause like, I don't wanna show like I'm scared, but my knees are going, rattling like, tick, 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 tick. And she's looking at them like, what are you scared of? And I'm like, nothing. But really and truly, like, this is a traumatic moment in my life. Never have I seen something like this. Anyway, one of my Rasta friends was over at the house earlier, and he decided, you know, that the things I'm about to see and hear in this night hour are going to be crazy, and I'm going to need the Bible more than him, so he left it on the table. How right he was. When I saw this thing coming at me, I was looking for some way to stop this thing because it didn't look real. So really and truly, when I saw that Bible, I picked it up because I know that God's word is true, you know? So I picked that thing up and I opened it up and I began to read, and this thing ran back from where it came to the washroom area, and she started screaming at me, you don't know what you're doing. That thing is way more powerful than you think. Put that down. Me, I started to regain some strength and some courage here, and I'm like, my knees stopped, started slowing down, and I'm like, oh, you're afraid of this, good. So I read 3 chapters, and that like encouraged and empowered me to be able to just relax. And now once I had that relax on, I put that Bible down, and I'm confident now. So I go sit down, I turn on the TV, she comes, sits beside me, and I'm like, yeah, you can be here, I could be here too, ain't no one scared of you. I'm flicking the channel, she's sitting there, I'm like, hey, don't try to play no games with my head, by the way. I got you on lock and all, you know? And she's looking at me, she's like, oh, you think there's only one way to kill you? We have many ways. At this time, I'm about to put a cigarette in my mouth. And I'm like, what did you say? She's just smiling at me, like a contorted smile, by the way, I didn't tell you. But when that smile goes off, it goes off. It goes off. One more time, it goes off. Like, people don't smile like that. But anyway, yeah, so she's like, we have more than one way to kill you. And I'm like, what? And I'm looking around like, what? And then I realized, yo, the cigarette, it was killing me because I was developing a cancer in my lungs. And I was like, really? Okay, here's what's gonna happen. Took every last cigarette, brand new pack. Took every last cigarette, crack, on the table. And then she's looking at me like, dang, as if he's doing this. But then I didn't realize there was one next cigarette in the pack. And I looked in there and I saw it. And I took it and I'm like, yo, what's really good? Crack. As I cracked that, I felt something jump out my chest. Real talk. Before this moment, if I was to breathe in more, than it would be coughing. After this moment, it was some deep breaths and then dancing and stuff like that.
This was just dancing and just rejoicing that God had healed me, you know. So
yeah, so after that, it was like I determined in myself, I'm going to church. Like nothing will stop me again, you know. So it was like I believe a Friday night or a Thursday night. What was it again? It was a Friday night. No, it was a Saturday night because Blundell had come back on the Friday and I came back the next night. Something was going on, you know, at the church, because usually they don't do night services. But yeah, it was a Saturday night and I came back, and then, you know, Pastor Grant was talking about someone needs to come forward, and I just decided I'm going forward. And I went forward and he put his hand on my stomach and he said, you're gonna feel something actually jump into your belly. And I'm like, yo, people always say stuff like this and then they touch you and you feel nothing. But for real, I felt something going within my stomach, and I was like, what? And it just, you know, it caused a breaking in my spirit. And, you know, like, when God wants to break you, you break, you know. So, yeah, I was broken before God that moment. And, yeah, it was a struggle to continuously come, because it's like every time, you know, something would cause me to doubt, or to cause me, not to doubt, actually, that's not true. It would be something would cause me to not want to attend the service, but I had to keep pressing through it and just know that God's word is true, and if whatever he wants for my life will be, and no demon in hell can stop it. And I just had to keep pressing, keep moving, and keep pressing, and keep moving, and keep pressing, to the point that it just became, you know, I'm back. And you know, that girl that I was bringing, you know, she got baptized, but then she fell off again. She's doing her own thing. But yeah, me, I came back, man. And I've been back. I've been appointed, you know, positions of responsibility now, positions in the church that, for real, it had to be God, because it's way too fast that I could be appointed to the positions I'm appointed. But God has a work for me to do, and I will do it. This is my testimony, Chosen Few TV.